Costumes, and also you will hear a little bit of Russian language, and we're going to show you some words written in Russian. My name is Mikhail Smirnov. I'm from Moscow, from the capital of Russia, and the balalaika virtuoso and dancer, her name is Irina Karohin. She's from St. Petersburg in Russia. We're going to play for you now the most famous American song ever written for Russian instrument, for the balalaika. Name of the song: Somewhere, My Love. This is from the movie about notorious Russian doctor Zhivago. Thank you. Спасибо. Thank you very much. Now I would like to introduce to you a traditional Russian instrument that is called garmoshka. This is a tiny accordion that has two rows of buttons. On the right side I have buttons with single notes. And on the left side I also have two rows of buttons with basses and chords. Now I'm going to sing for you very, very popular traditional Russian table song. When people, when Russian people having their parties, they usually consume a lot of traditional beverages. And when they're done with the beverages, they usually will sing a couple of songs. And this is the first song they're actually going to sing. It's called Moroz, Moroz. And this song, Russian gentleman is riding his horse back home. And he's talking to his horse and he's complaining that it's very cold. Traditional song and dance from Siberia. The name of this song, Metelica, which means in English the snowstorm. And our balalaika virtuoso and singer and also dancer Irina will show you how people used to dance the dance in Siberia. And the outfit she is wearing is actually a wedding dress from Siberia. Russian women in Siberia used to make dresses like that for their weddings about 250 years. Go in Siberia.
Постой, постой, красавица.
Russian tongue twisters. Won't bother me, yeah. I'm going to show you a couple of tongue twisters from Russia. Russian tongue twisters are kind of funny. They usually have no sense, but it's funny to tell them. First one is about a bird that didn't feel really good. And you're welcome to try to repeat those tongue twisters after me. Цапля чахла, цапля сохла, цапля сдохла. Next tongue twister, about four boys. They were drawing pictures with black ink very precisely. Четыре черненьки, черненьки, чертенка, четыре черные, чернилами, чертежки, означает четко.
It all begins with one letter, too,
which is unheard of in English. Yeah, the letter Ч doesn't exist in English language. The next tongue twister, about a gentleman named Грека. Грека was riding across the river when he saw lobster on the bottom. So he stopped and tried to grab lobster. And lobster suddenly snapped his finger. Ехал Грека через реку, видит Грека в реке рак, сунул Грека руку в реку, рак за руку в реку, цап! Спасибо. Спасибо. Next tongue twister is probably the most difficult Russian tongue twister. I'm going to say it slowly. This is about fishermen. They were fishing and exchanging one fish for another. I'm going to say it slowly first. На мели мы лениво, на лима ловили. Меняли на лима, мы на линя. Любви не меняли, вы мило молили. В туманы лимана манили меня. Now I'm going to say it very, very fast. На мели мы лениво, на лима ловили, меняли, на лима ловили, меняли, меняли, любви не меняли, в туманы лимана манили меня. And the last tongue twister I'm going to show you is a tongue twister song. This tongue twister song comes from south of Russia, from the Don River region, where we have our Cossacks. Cossacks are a very interesting kind of people. They kind of military formation, and they're very well known in the world for their friendly characters. I'm going to translate this tongue twister for you so you could kind of understand Cossack type of humor. The guy is singing to his girlfriend, Natalia, you are so beautiful. You have a white dress, you have blue eyes, and I'm so much in love with you that I want to kill myself. Then he says, no, why would I kill myself? It's easier to kill you. And then he's asking his friends, hey, bring me the fork, bring me the knife. I am going to kill Natalia. But in the end of the song, Natalia will survive only because of bad quality of Russian silverware. Because the knife is bent and the fork is broken. Да ты Наталья, Натальюша, да ты Наталья, алый цвет. Ты ворвана таборолья, наборвана лёрвуша, ты ворвана таборолья, аборвалый цвет. Личиком обела, бровки чёрные, да развесёлые глаза. Разворвор весёрвал, да ебер глаза. Ох, ревер вяжут северца без вырвы ножа. Режут сердце и печенку, да я влюбился у девчонку. Добровайте, добрый божий, добровайте виверинку, я ворвал за виверинку, с ворвою миверинку. Ты вырвана товаровалья, на ворворта любовуша, ты вырвана товаровалья, а ворвалый цвет. Ты вырвана товаровалья, на ворворта любовуша, ты вырвана товаровалья, а ворвалый цвет. Ты ворвана таборолья, на ворвоталё ворвуша, ты ворвана таборолья, а ворвалый цвет. Ты ворвана таборолья, на ворвоталё ворвуша, ты ворвана таборолья, 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 а ворвалый цвет. Всё. Спасибо, спасибо. Thank you very much. And we are having back our balalaika virtuosa, Ирина. And we're going to talk a little bit about the instrument that she is playing. This tiny three-string guitar made in Russia is called balalaika. Please repeat this word after me. Balalaika. Balalaika. It's actually, the word balalaika has a translation, which means belly scratcher, or in Russian, puzachos. Because when the lady or the gentleman is playing balalaika, he or him kind of scratching his or her belly. Balalaika has only three strings, and two of those strings are tuned exactly the same, E, E. And one string is tuned A. Musician that plays the balalaika does not use a pick, and the balalaika is strung with the bare fingers, because plastic used to be very, very expensive in Russia in old days. The song we're going to play for you now is called «Как заставил меня муж парную банюшку топить», which means «My husband forced me to do some very difficult job in the house that I refused to do anyway». Gypsies are called Tsigania, and they usually call themselves Roma people, but Russian people call them Tsigania anyway. They have a very interesting type of dancing and music, and Russian people just love their music. In old times, nobility and rich people, they could not imagine a party without gypsies, without Tsigania. And many Russian movies involve gypsy dancing and music. We're going to play for you the most famous Russian gypsy song that is called «Очи черные», which means dark eyes. By the way, most of Russian women, they usually have blue eyes, green eyes, or gray eyes, and it's extremely difficult to find a Russian lady with dark eyes. That's the reason Russian men, took off their usual habits and wrote a song of dark eyes. Очи черные, очи страстные, очи жгучие и прекрасные, как люблю я вас, как боюсь я вас. Сразу видел вас, я не добрый час. А в ничьем петербургском, а в ничьем чисто русскому жизнь нельзя прожить без шампанского, да и без стаба, без цыганского поцелуя. Ты мне нравишься, поцелуй меня. Нет, мать, как кажется, поцелуй меня. Потом я тебя, потом из тебя. Да, целуемся, эй! Очень страстные, очень
Я і прекрасна, яка любила вас, так боюся вас, я люблю вас. Я не добрий час, как люблю я вас, как боюся я вас, разлюбил вас. Я не добрий час.
Russian alphabet in Russian writing. Russian alphabet is called Cyrillic, and we have 33 letters. Would you like to grab some food, by the way? If you want, please, enjoy yourself. Grab some food. It's not very important what I'm going to show you. Yes, please, go ahead. So the first letter of Russian alphabet is letter R. It looks exactly like letter A in English alphabet. And the first word I'm going to show you is the way to say yes in Russian. Da. Da. You can repeat after me. Da. Next word is the way to say no in Russian. Нет.
Нет.
Very good. This is actually the way to say one in Russian. Один. I guess we're going to count to five now. Два. Два. Три. This is actually a little bit difficult. Would you please repeat after me? Because in Russian language, we don't have R, we only have R. So please try to say three. Three. Very good. Четыре. See this letter in green color? This is the last letter of Russian alphabet, letter Я. Would you like to hear Russian alphabet from beginning to the end?
Да.
Yes, listen carefully. А, Б, В, Г, Д, Е, Ё, Ж, З, И, И, Кратке, Г, Л, М, Н, О, П, Р, С, Д, У, Ф, Х, Ц, Ч, Ш, Щ, твердый знак И, мягкий знак Э, Ю, Я. And a few more words. This is a very nice word, the way to say thank you in Russian. Спасибо.
Спасибо.
This is the way to say you're welcome. Пожалуйста.
Пожалуйста.
This is the word to say hi. Привет. Привет. And the final word is the way to say bye. Пока.
Пока.
And if you're talking to your friends, it's usually you say paka paka, paka paka. Now we're going to perform for you a traditional song from south of Russia. It's a Cossack song that is called Pidmanula. In this song, young lady is promising to her man something different every day. She said on Monday we're going to do Bardina together. She never showed up. On Tuesday, she said, we're going to do some shopping together. Again, she never showed up. On Wednesday, she said, I'm going to kiss you 40 times. Never showed up. And every day, she's like, she's not keeping her promises. And the gentleman is kind of upset, and he's like, ты ж меня подманула, which means, you tricked me. By the way, the outfit she's wearing, we can call the outfit also Ukrainian outfit because the headpiece is from Ukraine, and I don't know what it's called in English, but it's a traditional Ukrainian thing. And many words in this song are also referred to Ukraine. Підманула, traditional song, and a little bit of dance too. Москва, Бричти.
Ты казала, помните, я пиво разом подарил, я пришел к тебе, либо ты манула, ты любила, ты же меня подманула, ты же не мила, і мене молодого заморозила. Казала, то не поселиш, я до себе пишу, то беріла, і мама вирила, і мене вирила, і мене вирила, і мене вирила, то заморозила. І казала, у себе обід, разом прошили, я пишу, то беріла, і мама вирила, і мене вирила, і мене вирила, і мене вирила, і
from around the world, and this is actually a very, very difficult medley. If any of you ever played musical instruments, you can see how difficult it is what she is going to do on her balalaika.
Сейчас.
going to sing for you. I'm going to sing for you a very old Russian song that is called Korobushka. Korobushka is the song that has been known in Russia for at least 133 years, according to Wikipedia. And also, sometimes people call the song Tetris song, because this song, for some reason, ended up in a computer game called Tetris. And also, I'm going to play for you the instrument. You probably forgot already the name of it, but it's called Garmoshka again. Can you please repeat after me? Garmoshka.
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 Раз, два, три, четыре. By the way, you are welcome to grab some food. Yeah, please. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, you can stand up. Some Russian percussion instruments. Who is not eating? Did you get that? Because they are cooking for this instrument.
Any volunteers to play our
instrument? Yeah, we're going to play together Russian song "Katyusha." This song has been known in Russia since 1942. And the instruments we're going to give you, they are very, very easy to play, but the names of the instruments are really difficult to say. So this instrument is called prishchotka. Please repeat after me, prishchotka.
Prishchotka.
So we can have a... And this instrument is called Vertushka.
We need one more.
Yeah, we need one more person. Natalie, you're going to be our conductor, because yeah. Russian people cannot do a thing without a conductor.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now, we would like to play for you one more song. This song is called Denise is going to play for you method of Russian songs. And but before that, we would like to find a few volunteers to do Russian dance with us. Anybody interested to learn some Russian dancing? Yeah, come here, please. The dance we're going to do is called Parina. This is the most famous Russian folk dance. Usually people before doing the dance need to consume certain Russian beverages. So please repeat after Alina what she is doing.
Пожалуйста, пока.
До свидания.
Вы говорите по-русски?
Да.
Да?
Конечно.
Так а переведите. Сейчас я для вас буду играть русскую народную песню «Светит месяц». И вы увидите танец из Ярославля. Now I will play for you Russian folk song. The moon is shining brightly, and you will see dance from Yaroslavl region of Russia. And don't be scared, we don't have live animals in our show.
Thank you so much for playing. Just a reminder, this is for the release of The Bird, which is playing on the screen behind you guys. We are running into printing issues, kind of, but we have the version that we have right now up there, so if you want to take a look. And if you want to take pictures, please.
All right.